The System Restore feature in Microsoft Windows allows user to revert their computer state to a previous point that can be used to recover from system malfunctions and other Windows-related problems. When you run System Restore to revert to a previous point of Windows running state, then it undo the changes made to system files, installed programs, Windows registry, and other Windows settings. System Restore was first introduced in Windows ME. Since then it has been included in all the following desktop Windows versions, up to Windows 10. Depending on System Restore configuration, most of the time Windows automatically creates new restoration point before the significant system change, like installing new drivers or applications. To understand it in more details, let's first open the System Restore utility. In Windows 10 and Windows 8, you can access System Restore by right-clicking on the Start button, and then click System. From the left side pane, click System Protection. You can also access System Restore through Control Panel. Open Control Panel, and in the large icons view, click Recovery, and then click Configure System Restore. You can also access System Window by right-clicking on Computer icon, and then choose Properties, and then click System Protection from the right side pane. Under Protection Settings window, you can see that for which drive System Protection is on. To turn on or off System Protection for a particular drive, select the drive and then click Configure. From the Restore settings, you can either disable System Restore for a particular drive, or can turn on the System Protection. Most of users turn on System Protection just for the drive where Windows is installed. If you have separate configurations, then you can turn on System Protection for other drives as well, and can configure different storage usage for each drive. Below you can configure the disk space that you want to reserve for the system restoration points. If the specified space fills up, then Windows will automatically delete the old restoration points. You can also delete all the previously saved restoration points by clicking the Delete button. Anytime when you think that your Windows is running in good state, or you are going to install apps or update your system, then you can create a System Restore point at your own by clicking the Create button. Type a descriptive name of your restore point, and then click Create. Whenever you feel that your system is malfunctioning after a major update, then you can restore your system to a previous state by clicking on System Restore. Do remember that when you run a System Restore and revert your Windows to a previous state, then no changes are made to your documents, pictures and other user files stored on the same drive. For instance, if you have created a restoration point last week before installing Microsoft Office, and a week later you restore your system to the same date, then all the files that you had created using Microsoft Office will remain safe on your system. So you don't need to worry about them. After clicking Next, you will see all the available restoration points. You can also make a check mark on Show More Restore Points to see all the other Windows-generated restoration points. Choose a desired restoration point, and then click Next. Clicking Finish will start the system restoration and Windows will restart. The time to complete the system restoration may differ depending on the system configuration changes. Once the entire process is completed, Windows will start normally, and you will see a message stating if the restoration was completed successfully. So this was all about configuring, creating and restoring System Restore points. Before we go, let me tell you one more thing. The method we discussed earlier to restore your Windows to a previous state will only work if your Windows is at least running in a state where you can access the system protection feature. But what if you are unable to boot into Windows, or unable to access system protection? Then you require accessing system restore before Windows start. You may require using advanced boot options. You can watch our video about enabling F8 boot menu for advanced boot options. If you are unable to access system protection feature, then a quick way to access advanced recovery options is to hold down shift key, and then click restart from the shutdown menu. This command will then immediately start advanced recovery options. Then click troubleshoot, and then click advanced options. Click system restore and your PC will get restarted. Then your system will prepare itself for a system restore. Select username, and then type the password, and hit continue. Click the next button, and choose a restoration point, and then click next. Clicking finish will immediately start restoring your system to the specific restoration point. But as I said earlier, these recovery options will only work if you are at least able to get into your Windows system. If Windows itself fails to load, then you can use the F8 advanced recovery options, only if you have pre-configured them. You can watch our video to know how to configure advanced recovery option before system crash. If you have not configured advanced recovery option before a system crash, then your only options to boot from Windows bootable media. Configure your BIOS to boot from Windows media, either from removable device, or CD, DVD drive, and let the Windows setup begin. Click the next button, add language, time and keyboard settings. Click repair your computer, and then click troubleshoot. Choose advanced options, and then click system restore. The rest procedure is same as described earlier. If you like our videos, then don't forget to leave a comment and share our videos with your friends. Do subscribe to our channel, as there are a lot more videos to come. Bye for now, and have a nice day.